that he would reveal his secret unto his servants, the prophets. Then his son Jesus came and backed him up, and Matthew recorded in 5 and 7, because there has been a prophet among you.
The young people's joy, their desire to be united together at this historical time and place, has astonished one and all.
Well,
it is with special affection I greet the delegates of the 1997 National Youth Convention. The church is alive in you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I'm happy to be here with you.
Yes, sir.
This is Lawrence, Kansas.
Yes.
Where's my cat? Jayhawker's cat.
We have come to continue a spiritual trip pilgrimage begun in 1896 at this very place.
Well,
101 years ago, a man by the name of William Saunders Crowdy,
well,
one whom we esteem as the prophet of God, came to Lawrence, Kansas and established the Church of God and Saints of Christ.
Well,
this great spiritual pilgrimage was started in Lawrence in November the 8th, 1896, brought us to this device, brought us from diverse points across America to Canada to Jamaica, West Indies, to Cape Town, South Africa, to London, England, to Bermuda, and today back here to Lawrence. What a mighty God we serve. The Spirit of God, who we are told in the book of Genesis, breathed upon the waters at the beginning of creation, is the same Spirit of life, and it is the same Spirit of life that was breathed into man so that man became a living being. This is what makes us different from every other creature in the whole material world. Today and throughout this weekend, I invite you to reflect on what makes each one of you truly marvelous and unique. Only a human being like you can think and speak and share your thoughts with others. And most important of all, only God's precious human beings are capable of loving. Love makes us seek what is good. Love makes us a better person. It is love that prompts men and women to marry and form a family, to have children. It is love that prompts others to embrace the religious life. Love makes you reach out to others. Indeed, whoever they are, wherever they are. In the fourth chapter of 1 John, the 8th verse instructs us that he that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love.
Well, say so, Bishop.
Our celebration today speaks to us not only of the past, but also to the future fulfillment of God's plan of salvation. The youth of the Church of God and Saints of Christ have returned to Lawrence this weekend.
Yes, sir.
To bear witness. To the love of Christ and to continue on in their pilgrimage of faith. Today I offer this humble prayer for strengthening of that vitality and Christian courage at every level of the church, among the young, among the old, among the ministers and lay members. In St. Luke chapter 17, verse 5, the apostles asked Jesus to increase our faith. Today, this must be our constant prayer. Faith is always demanding, because faith leads us beyond ourselves. It leads us directly to God. Faith also imparts a wisdom, a vision of life purpose. And stimulates us to action. The gospel of Jesus Christ is not a private opinion, a remote spiritual ideal, or a mere program for personal growth. The gospel is the power which can transform the world.
Well,
The gospel is no abstraction. It is the living person of Jesus Christ, the Word of God. Jesus commanded us to allow the Word of God to inspire us and direct our thinking, our activity, and our decision. My prayers are with you and your families. May Almighty God bless you always and strengthen you with the grace and peace that you may continue to serve Him in the service you give to your fellow men. I can only give you the number of the psalm. Lord, Thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the world was formed, but before the earth was formed, the mountain above forth, the earth was formed, even from everlasting to everlasting, Thou art God. God bless and keep each and every one. At this time, we want to bring up Bishop Robert Stallings of New Haven, Connecticut, to receive him with a round of applause.
All right now, all right. Come on up, Bishop.
We thank God for this day.
Yes, sir.
Let the church say amen. To the city officials here in Lawrence, Kansas, to the citizens of Lawrence, we feel as though you're blessed today.
Well, say so.
Because of the former presence of William Saunders Crowder. And it becomes my task to dedicate this plaque that will remain here in this city in the honor of William Saunders Crowley. This brings us to the dedication of this plaque in honor of our founder, Prophet William S. Crowley. We pause momentarily to reflect on the many noble deeds of our founder. We today are reaping the rewards of his steadfast loyalty to the principles of the organization and the many sacrifices he made. It is up to us who are here today to see that this great organization for which he laid the foundation perpetuates the godly work begun by him.
Amen.
This plaque is a perpetual testimony of the honored memory of William Saunders Crowley.
Oh, yes.
Revelation 7:12,
yes,
saying amen, blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we now turn the remaining of the procedures of the parade over to Evangelist Robert Grant and Deacon Kyle Stewart. As we continue to await our instructions from our general, let it be known that at the conclusion, at the end of the parade, we will end up at South Park, which is down at 11th Avenue in Massachusetts, where we will be refreshed after the parade is concluded. Thank you. Can we please have everyone's undivided attention? We're going to ask those with banners to proceed to the front at this time, and to please line up accordingly upon their...
In the van.
Yeah. Thank you.
He don't know Kansas whether he's with us or not.
We're done for the weekend.
Amen.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done in earth.
Thy will be done in earth.
As it is in heaven.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day.
Give us this day.
Our daily bread.
Our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts.
And forgive us our debts.
As we forgive our debtors.
As we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation.
And lead us not into temptation.
But deliver us from evil.
But deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom.
For thine is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the power.
And the glory.
And the glory.
Forever.
Forever. Amen. Amen.
will all hear. With our whole heart, soul, mind, and his mercy is everlasting, and the truth endures throughout all generations. Come to the church of God.
Again, it is good for us to be assembled in what we have deemed to be the tabernacle for the weekend, 814. And to the bishop, Bishop Brandon is asking, Bishop Stallings, and to the chief of the pulpit, and to the ministers assembled, to the sister elders, the deacons, and to the choir officials and all here, it's really good for us to be here. I reiterate it, I really don't think we understand how good it is for us to be here. Not only is it good for us as a church, but it's also good for the community.